And it means that Great Britain and Ireland need 1.5 points from the remaining matches if they are to regain this Walker Cup. I did laugh at the chest bump with Nigel Edwards. There's one or two former Walker Cup players here, obviously, this week, including Charlie Green from my own club, Cardross, who was a 5-time player and 2-time captain. I'd love to have seen Charlie to do that, I must say. Let's hear from these two players in that wonderful match we've just enjoyed.
How was G1?
Well, suddenly the wind seems to have dropped just when you boys are finished, Jack and Nathan. That was a tremendous battle and a battle of wills. What was your take on it, Nathan?
Well, I mean, Jack's such a great player. I was fortunate to hang in the match as long as I did with him. I mean, he's one of the best players on their team and all of GB and I. And I watched how he played in the amateur this year, and he played so well. So I was fortunate to stay with him. I knew that, you know, he was going to make a move at the end. He's that type of player, and I knew he had one bullet left in the chamber. I actually was expecting to make that putt, and I was hoping maybe I could run one in, but it didn't happen. But he's a great player, and it was a great match.
Well, Jack, a birdie putt there on the last to snatch the half. How did that feel for you?
Yeah, I mean, the emotions were seriously running high when it went in the hole. To be honest, I think I've not really held anything all afternoon, so it's great to finally one dropped.
And how aware of you going round, Jack, were you of the overall scores?
I mean, I had a few little peeks at the scoreboard and stuff, but just concentrating on my own game, really. I didn't really look at the scoreboard, to be honest, but I don't know. I'm going to go back out there now and support the guys, and hopefully it's good enough.
Nathan, still nail-biting that the Americans aren't out of this yet?
Well, we'll see. I think our match was so intense, I didn't have a chance to look at the scoreboard. I thought our match was really big, and that was probably going to be big for the GB and I, that Jack maybe grabbed a half there. But hopefully, you know, something can happen. I'm like Jack, I'm going to go out and cheer him on, see what happens.
Well, well played, both of you. Great entertainment. Thanks.
Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Absolutely. Yep. Very sporting, eh, Andrew? Very sporting.
Yeah, it's good to see you took it in good part. As you mentioned, the career amateur all the time. Mentioned that Nathan Smith, he's been here before on a winning side in 2009 for America. Might well be on a losing side today. Let's go down to Stiggy Hodgson against Peter Uihlein. One up at the moment, Stiggy Hodgson.
Yes, Stiggy Hodgson in the hole for a four, but this, after a beautifully controlled 8-iron from Peter Uihlein, 113 yardage for a three, and to square the match just inside right.
It's not all over yet. It is not all over yet.
United States with the hole.
You're keeping only 1.5 points.
The match is all square.
So Stiggy and Peter, all square as they clamber up onto the 16th tee.